So it seems like my quest now is for mastery, personal mastery. You know, I can only really control what I do, but there's a lot of things that I can't control, and that's what mastery is all about. I want to be able to go hungry for 48 hours. I want to, the things that scare me, I want them to know, I want there to be nothing that scares me. You know, there's things that hold you back. Do you know that feeling where maybe you have a bad breakup and you're like, oh, I can't go on that side of town because my ex goes there and that, and then there's this person that I don't like that works there, so I can't go in there. That's a bad feeling to know that there's parts of the map that you just can't go to. And I think, you know, we have our own versions, our own things that relate. If someone says, hey, tomorrow, let's go skydiving, here's the tickets, I want to be able to go. And I don't think I can do that right now. I want to be able to go hungry for 2 days at a time, 48 hours, and I can only make it like I'm good for 10 hours. And that's on the best days. So there's mastery. I want a mastery. I want, you know, a sufficient amount of weight. I want to just be like, oh, you don't think I could pull that? Boom, pull, you know, deadlift, you know, 500 pounds right there on the floor, cold. And be like, oh, wow, this guy, he can do anything. I want to be able to purchase anything. I want to be able to, you know, all aspects of my life. The ultimate expression of power is control. And I want power over my own life because I have all the best intentions. And I want to be able to express them to their fullest, greatest potential and power. And when I want to change someone's life, I want to do it right there. You know, I don't want to just want to change someone's life. I want to go change someone's life. And if that's my life, you know, first, I must possess the power over my own body. Mastery, self-mastery, you know, financially. Oh, there's so many things, like little small business things that, you know, I really don't want to do that. And it's just uncomfortable. And, you know, got to make 1,000 calls and only one of them's going to work. And it's just a stressful thing. But I don't want to avoid anything. I don't want anything holding me back. There's things in my brain. I hate that feeling. And I think it's a poison and a gift. And it's not a gift, but it's a curse that humans have where I know what I should do. I'm just not doing it. I just want to be like, this is what I'm doing, boom, do it, regardless of how I feel about it, regardless how it, you know, how it keeps me up at night. You know, you're not having power over me. You know, there's people that actively hate someone, and we know all about this, 2020, actively hate someone. For example, I drive by someone's house all the time, and he's got a big-ass Trump sign on his lawn, and he's got Trump stuff all over his house, and I see him out in the yard, he's got Trump hats on, and regardless of your point of view, you know that you have a version of power over that person, because they're gonna react regardless of what you say. If you want to be his friend, you say, oh, I love Trump, da 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 da, and then all of a sudden, maybe you could sell him, or there's a certain way that you've kind of squeezed your way into his liking. You know exactly how to manipulate that person. That's a version of power. And they hate someone so much, all you got to do is say, I hate Trump. And you just wait, and then they explode, and you knew exactly how to pull them. But I want to be able to have so much mastery that I make the decisions here. If I want to go lose weight, I just go do it. You know, there's nothing holding me back. The biggest thing holding us back is ourselves. You got to understand that the biggest thing holding us back is me. My biggest weakness is not somebody else. It's not a food. It's this. And I want to train this. I want to master this. And I want to find a way to have the ultimate expression of power in my life. And that's control. Control over everything. Because I know what's best for myself and those around me. And if I don't have control over that, then I can't do anything about it. I think it would be best if you pay off your credit cards and stop paying interest, and you'll be out of debt. But you don't have control over your finances, and you don't have control over, there's so many things that we can do that we do have control over, but we're not expressing that power in our own lives. And I'm gonna, you know, dedicate my life, because this is not a on-off thing. I gotta start figuring out how to master all these different areas of my life. And I want to see, potentially, there's other like-minded people like me. So throughout my journey, I'm going to try to cultivate those people. And, you know, I want to raise you up to the top. That's why I've created my brand Push. There's a few brands underneath Push Incorporated. And I want to be able to highlight those people that also are pushing their life to that limit. You know, I want to be like, look at this. On Team Push, we got some other badasses out there really trying to control their life to the max. not control by like confining it, controlling it by pushing it up to the max. That's what life is all about, is controlling every aspect of your life. There's nothing that has power over you. Food, disciplines, there's nothing that, whether you want to do it or not, that you won't do. Because there's stuff that we know we should be doing that we just don't do. And the fact is, there should be nothing in your brain holding you back, because you have ultimate control over this. And the huge issue is when people crave something, if you crave it, now you're a slave to it. And that's how it works, is there's people that want to lose weight, they just can't, you know, their life, they're, you know, people are not talking about it. People are not talking about this, but we are all, how are you eating out 3 times a day? How are you paying for that? First of all, good for you, but why are you, you're coping for something like, oh man, and I know it, because at the end of a long day, I'm thinking of, I could go buy this type of food, you know, I'm thinking of all my favorite foods right now, and that would make my night a little bit better, and I'm like, why is it I need food to make my night a little bit better? That's a problem. That's the root of the problem, and I need to address that. So, rant